آمنت بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر والقدر خيره وشره من الله والبعث بعد الموت لا إله إلا الله.
Jummah prayers. So now, why is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a Jummah shorter, 2 rakah? Normally Zuhr is 4 rakah, 2 rakah. There's wisdom behind it, and read it loud. The first week of the Friday is a Jummah, like Eid celebration. So now, we pray 2 rakah of the Imam, plus we listen to the khutbah. This is part of Salah. The one who's listening to the khutbah is part of the Salah, because Allah reduced 4 rakah to 2 rakah, and he added the khutbah part of Salah. So the khutbah is part of Salah. So now when we have 2 azan, we're discussing about 2 azan. First azan is for you to pray sunnah. The second azan is time for Imam. The khutbah means this is the khutbah is Salah. So we are in a state of prayers. So when the khutbah is Imam, when Imam and Mimbar speaks, you keep silent, you can't talk. If you talk, you can listen, because you are in a state of prayer. You keep quiet, but you have to listen. Right, and when Imam finishes, then your one part of the khutbah is Allah is done. Then you have to keep quiet until you pray Jama'ah. Then this is the Jama'ah. So the khutbah is part of Salah. You have to be in state of wudu. If you break your wudu, you go make wudu come back. Right. So that doesn't mean that if you break it, you have to go back and make wudu come back. It's permissible. Now you stay in wudu because you have to wait for the Imam to, when you finish, he prays Allah. So the khutbah, when Imam speaks, you are state of Salah. Don't speak. Listen is obligation. If you speak, you are committing sin. Does it break your wudu? No, it doesn't. But you commit a sin by talking to a person. So when an Imam in khutbah, you listen. You can't say, if someone says wa alaikum salam, you can't say wa alaikum salam. If someone gives you a move. Or just indication. That's it. You can indicate, say, brother, can I sit here? Just move. Or give indication. If someone just comes to you, just move and just your hand, go there. Don't speak, just go in the space there. So he should give understanding like the space there. He shouldn't talk. If he talks to you, you keep quiet. Don't listen. No? So then after, this is part of the khutbah, right? If you speak, you come in. Right? So when the khutbah is finished, when the Imam finishes, when he says, Waqim Salah, then you go straight away, pray Salah. And when you go to the Imam and he prays Salah, the Imam can say straight to the line, he can speak. Right? Now the question is, now if someone comes in and distracts you, you can't speak. The Imam has permission to speak. No one can speak. When the khutbah starts, all the person who can speak to the person is the Imam. He can't reply back to the Imam. He can speak. He has the permission to speak, because the khutbah is delivering a talk. If he comes in and says, where is my space? He can say, sit down there. For him it's allowed, because he's the Imam. And the people around him, you can't say, go and sit down there, you can't. You should listen to the Imam. The Imam, the one who is a rule, right? So if someone comes late into the Friday prayers, and Imam says, come, sit there. He can do that, because the Imam, he speaks and sit down there, keep quiet. He allowed to say, keep quiet, right? So now, this is the Imam. If we speak, the Salah is finished. The first part of the Salah is part of Salah, right? Don't destroy that.